V7 and V7 Plus present The News Hour at 9. Driven by Hyundai. Co-powered by Cisco. Light years ahead.
Ladies and gentlemen, on Monday, Times Now investigation into the circumstances surrounding Judge Loya's death blew a hole in the foul play angle that is being pushed by an aggressive lobby of self-proclaimed conscience keepers. If yesterday's investigation based on medical reports cornered the lobby, tonight two explosive sting operations will reveal the desperation of the Congress-led opposition and the lobby trying to push an RSS hand theory. Listen in to these soundbites.
Congress basically. तो ये लोग तो बोले थे कि आरएसएस के लोग हैं इनको
किसी को भी पूछ लो
कांग्रेस के यार
मैं सिद्धांत बात कर रहा हूँ टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया से ठीक है सर मुझे आपसे पूछना था ये जो बहेती हॉस्पिटल वाले हैं है ना आप लातूर में बहेती सर ये कांग्रेस के मेंबर हैं क्या ये लोग
बड़े आदमी है पे हो गए विलासराव देशमुख सूरत पटेल होम मिनिस्टर
हाँ हाँ
आना जाना रहता है सब तो कांग्रेस से जुड़े वाले वो तो कांग्रेस माइंडेड है समझो
Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the case. It's my job every night to present to you the case and for you to be the judge based on the arguments that are presented to you in the debate on the News Hour. And tonight I present to you the case that is just a sliver of an explosive investigation report that we are about to expose on the News Hour tonight. Part two of the Judge Loya investigation venturing into the political aspect of the controversy that is being pushed hard. A desperate opposition and an obsessed lobby that is looking to concoct theories to fix their rivals. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, two exclusive sting operations will blow the lid off a fabricated theory that aims to give a political hue to the controversy where none exists. The repeated assertion that an RSS-linked man was the first to call up the close relatives of the Judge Loya family has been debunked tonight. The first to debunk the theory is Dr. Pawan Ladda, who adds a fresh twist by claiming that the man projected to be the RSS-linked operative was indeed a Congress sympathizer, throwing a sensational twist to the case. It was not just Dr. Ladda who called the informer a Congress sympathizer, but the Congress Latur president only confirmed that this Ishwar Baheti, who informed others of Judge Loya's death, were actually Congress-minded individuals. Stunning details in just a few minutes. But before I go to that, I put out to you, ladies and gentlemen, my legitimate question tonight. Is the Congress-led opposition and this self-styled lobby fabricating an anti-narrative, anti-BJP narrative very, very suspiciously? That's the legitimate question coming up in just a bit from now. The debate on the News Hour tonight. Judge Loya plot thickens. That's the debate coming up in just a bit from now. But first up, let's take a look at the top headlines making news this Tuesday evening. After busting the foul play theory floated by the lobby in the Judge Loya death case, Times Now takes its investigation a step further, exposes the second claim by the lobby on the alleged RSS link to the case. Times Now tracks down the first man to inform Loya family about the judge's death. Dr. Ladda crushes the RSS hand theory, says it was indeed a Congress sympathizer who informed him, not an RSS man, as claimed by the lobby.
तो मेरी जिम्मेवारी बनती है कि उनके लिए मुझे सही सोचना चाहिए, मैं बिल्कुल उनके साथ हूँ।
ये घटना की इंडिपेंडेंट जांच होनी चाहिए और सत्य बाहर आना चाहिए।
Dramatic twist in Gujarat politics, Congress ally and strongman rush to bigot's bedside. Hardik Patel and Arjun Morwadia meet Praveen Trogaria. Does Rahul Gandhi endorse Congress VHP tango?
Hajj subsidy 2018 ke Hajj ke baad nahi rahegi, 2018 mein ke Hajj mein nahi rahegi.
NDA government says no to appeasement, ends Hajj subsidy from this year, says move part of center's policy to empower minorities with dignity. A year later, perverts still run amok in Bengaluru. Shocking CCTV visuals reveal absolute hooliganism by miscreants on New Year's Eve. They assault, molest and thrash commuters in drunken revelry.
You're watching the News Hour at 9.
Dear viewers, the second part of Times Now's investigation into the storm brewing around Judge Lawyer's death completely corners the foul play lobby, which has been subtly hinting at a larger conspiracy. Times Now has tracked down the personae dramatis who clearly demolished the main claim of this foul play lobby. Here's the report.
20 तारीख को लोया जी नागपुर आए थे, 1 तारीख को सीने में दर्द हुआ, 1 तारीख की सुबह उनको ट्रीटमेंट के लिए हॉस्पिटल वहां गए, वहां यही रिवील हुआ कि उनकी चेस्ट सीने में जो दर्द हो रही है और उसका कारण हृदय संबंधित बीमारी है और उसकी ट्रीटमेंट जो मेडिट्रेना हॉस्पिटल में की गई और वहां सीवियर हार्ट अटैक जो कोरोनरी इंसफिशिएंसी है उसकी वजह से हुई।
A day after a mega Times Now investigation revealing 5 medical reports which demolished any claims of foul play in Judge Lawyer's death, part 2 of Times Now investigation is even more explosive.
Times Now debunks the RSS hand theory pushed by lobby, tracks down Dr. Ladda who first visited the lawyer family, and Dr. Ladda has branded the alleged RSS link a Congress sympathizer. This is a sudden twist in this story.
The main claim of the foul play lobby completely demolished.
And he's associated to Congress.
Congress के अलावा दूसरा कोई है नहीं यहाँ पे। ये जो बीजेपी हो गई जो है अभी 2-3 सालों।
And he's associated to Congress.
अगर 1% by birth.
By birth.
उसके बाद में कोई दूसरा वर्ड ही नहीं by birth.
Confirmed by none other than a top local Congress leader.
लेकिन कांग्रेस से जुड़े हुए रहते
हैं। अभी कैसा है भारत में, वो तो बड़े आदमी हैं, फिर हो गए विलासराव देशमुख, सूरज पटेल, होम
मिनिस्टर।
हाँ हाँ। आना जाना रहता है सब, वो तो कांग्रेस से जुड़े वाले, वो तो कांग्रेस माइंडेड है समझो।
कांग्रेस माइंडेड है ना
ये, उनसे कांग्रेस के पदाधिकारी वो नहीं।
Meanwhile, even more members of the lawyer family came out to claim that they don't have any suspicions about the death.
आपको क्या लगता है कि कुछ हो
सकता है? कुछ भी बोलना नहीं।
आपको लगता है इसमें किसी का? हाँ, उन्होंने तो बोलते हैं कि कुछ नहीं है। आप भी नहीं मानते?
वही।
आप भी नहीं मानते? कुछ भी नहीं है ना?
कुछ भी नहीं।
नहीं, हम वो बच्चे के साथ सहमत है। बच्चा बोलते मेरा नातू पोता अनुज ब्रिजमोहन लोया ब्रिज बापा उसने जो कुछ कहा उससे हम सहमत।
टाइम्स नाउ आल्सो स्पोक टू द अदर सिस्टर ऑफ जज लोया हु हैड अर्लियर रेज्ड क्वेश्चंस।
सर्टेन रिपोर्ट्स हैव पॉइंटेड आउट सेइंग दैट ही डाइड ऑफ नेचुरल कॉजेज, सो वी जस्ट वांटेड योर टेक मैम, व्हाट इज द सेम ऑन द व्हाट डू यू हैव टू से अबाउट द सेम।
So has the foul play lobby been playing political games all along? Bureau Report, Times Now.
You're watching the News Hour at 9. Debate number 1 on Times Now. Super Prime Time.
And joining me on the Judge Lawyer Plot Thickens debate tonight is Dr. Sambit Patra, National Spokesperson of the BJP, Hitesh Jain, Senior Lawyer, Paranjoy Guha Thakurta, Senior Journalist with me in our studios in Noida, Dr. John Dayal, Activist and Human Rights Activist also with me in our studios in Noida, Dr. Dinesh Vashne, Leader of the CPI, Rajiv Desai, Public Affairs Analyst joining me live from Delhi, and Rajiv Rai, Spokesperson of the Samajwadi Party, joining me live from Bengaluru. Before I open up the debate, let's go to our section that's called The Standpoint. And tonight on The Standpoint, Rajiv Desai will take on Dr. Sambit Patra. And Mr. Rajiv Desai, the rules of the game are 60 seconds to you for your point of view, and in 60 seconds, you have to make your point, after which it will be 60 seconds to Dr. Sambit Patra to counter you in his 60 seconds. My first question to you, Dr. Rajiv Desai, is there a deliberate attempt by the Congress-led opposition as well as this lobby which has been trying to push the foul play angle? Because first they talked about the medical reports, which is a theory that we busted yesterday with 5 exclusive reports, the viscera reports, pathology reports, also the post-mortem reports, all of which pointed towards one direction. Tonight, we've shown you the man who was called the RSS connect in this entire issue actually is a congressman. So which way does this investigation really point directions? Where does the foul play come in from?
Obviously, I have a completely different view on this. You can't expect a party with 44 seats in a few states to engage in this conspiracy against his government, who not only controls everything, but actively does it and shows that it does. It's got influence on the judiciary, it's got influence on the election commission, it's got influence on everything. So I completely disagree with it. I think the real question to ask, Navika, is the best way for the government, giving them the benefit of the doubt, is to say, yes, okay, that everybody's raised questions about this guy's death. Supreme Court is inquiring, so let the inquiry go ahead. Instead, after the inquiry is placed before the Supreme Court, the Nagpur police are sort of prodded to say deny the previous statement that they made, saying that we decided there
your
was no foul play.
Your 60 seconds are up.
And then say that
Mr.
no, we
Rajiv
never said anything like
your
that.
60 so, seconds are up.
So anyway.
Okay, your 60 seconds are up. So let me go across to Dr. Sambit Patra. Dr. Sambit Patra, do you think even before the Supreme Court had gone into this entire case, should the Nagpur police have come out and said what they did, number one? And number two, what happens to this RSS hand theory that was propounded by the so-called lobby?
See, Navika, as far as these lobbyists are concerned, these lobbyists can go to any extent. They can conspire to any extent. They have nothing to do with Judge Lohia. Do you think they're fighting for justice of Judge Lohia? They're fighting, they've smelled blood, and their only concern is power. These are power-hungry lobbyists, and out of power, they will conspire. Secondly, no one is right. The two judges who accompanied Judge Lohia, the doctors, the histopathological reports, the autopsy report, the policemen, news channels, Indian Express, Times of India, no one is right. Only they and their caravan are the ones who are the gospel truth, and their great Rahul Gandhi. Only these people are right. Baki Supreme Court's benches, even Supreme Court benches, they're quite junior, you know, they are not competent enough to look into these cases. Thirdly, and most importantly, I would like to say, the kind of behavior that the Congress party has shown in these last few days only smells of power hunger. I mean, look, they have even commented upon the Supreme Court's integrity when they question the judges who are going to hear this case.
Time up.
When the Supreme Court is seized of the matter.
Time up, Dr. Sambit Patra. 60 seconds are up, and now I open up this debate. Let me get in Paranjoy Guha Thakurta. Paranjoy Guha Thakurta, the Ishwar Baheti angle was brought in by the Caravan magazine. Now, the Caravan magazine said they had researched this entire issue. They had been in touch with this family, which brought in the Baheti angle, for 1 year. And for 1 year, they tried to contact Baheti and couldn't get through.
Did you try to contact him?
We tried to contact
him. You never said it. That's why I'm asking you.
I'm asking you a question first.
Okay, sure. I'll answer you.
Yeah. So, Baheti and Ladda. Ladda is the man Baheti called and asked to go to the sister's house. Caravan didn't even try to get in touch with Ladda. The first phone call, the first time we contact Ladda, now Ladda comes out and says Baheti is not even an RSS hand.
Can so I ask why, you another why, question, why, a clarification?
No, you don't ask me, you a answer. Clarification. You answer the question.
Was it a sting that you did on Dr. Pawan Ladda, or did he voluntarily give the statement? I want to know.
It was a sting that we did.
I see.
Yeah.
All right.
Now that you've seen, what's your answer?
Okay,
if Pawan Ladda says that Baheti was not a RSS man, then why did Caravan try to give an impression that he was?
You are depending on Pawan Ladda's word given to you in a sting operation. You are depending on Sheikh Mohijuddin Naimuddin's word, where he says he belongs, he's a Congress-minded person, to put a placard saying he's a proclaimed Congress sympathizer. You tried very hard to put words in the mouth of Padma Nandha, the late judge's sister, but she didn't want to talk. I'm so sorry, Navika. Let me conclude. You know, the Caravan article, and I'm not a part of Caravan. I'm part of no lobby, okay? Just as I presume you're not any part of any lobby. The RSS angle, there were three aspects to the RSS angle. One was Ishwar Baheti. Now you say he's a Congress person and not an RSS person. Okay, but you don't have it from his mouth. You are depending on his neighbor or Justice
Lawyer. The man who he called.
One minute.
Go and meet the family.
1 minute.
The man who he happens to know very well, number one. And number two.
It's all what you are saying.
Mr. Paranjoy.
No, you please also go to Mr. Baheti. I didn't see you saying we went to Mr. Ishwar Baheti, we asked him a question, he refused to talk. I didn't get that bit. One minute. Navika, please. Just as yesterday evening, you guys recycled an old story to make a thing, and I'm repeating what I've said. The Caravan story, if you go through it, there were two other so-called BJP stroke RSS angles. And may I highlight what those are? Because you're not touching about those. The person, Pinak Dande, of Dande Hospital, stood for elections for the Maharashtra Medical Council from a panel which was affiliated to the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh. Two, the investigating officer, Sunil Bonde, he's a brother of Anil Bonde, who happens to be a member of the Legislative Assembly of Maharashtra belonging to the BJP. So, I am here saying that you people are going hammer and tongs at a story when the Supreme Court is seized of the matter. How does it matter what a police officer has to say, what the Joint Commissioner of Police Nagpur has to say, what the police head of Latur has to say, when the Supreme Court is...
Now, if your monologue is over, may I come in and ask you the questions that I want to...
Oh, you mean I'm the only person allowed a monologue and not you? Go on.
Yeah. I mean, let's be fair. Both of us should have the right to counter question. I ask you, number one, when Caravan wrote its piece, it wrote about Baheti being an RSS person. You are not commenting on why it came to that conclusion. You have not. You have sidestepped. You are accusing us of sidestepping several questions. You have sidestepped the moot point. One minute. You have sidestepped the moot point. Point number two, the recycling, as you say, of the documents that we are talking about. The only report that the Caravan magazine relies upon is the postmortem report, of which one page, page number two, was put out by the magazine. Fair enough. Maybe they have the other 8 pages. We had the 9 pages in which we put out all of the 9 pages yesterday. But we had two other reports which were there. Number one, the report of the viscera, which talked about no poisoning. We had the report of the histopathology. Please go back and ask and go back and read that magazine if it had the histopathology and the viscera report. It did not.
Okay.
It did not.
Now, so will you give me a chance
if you would
Navika,
be magnanimous enough
seconds.
To concede that point. Point number three,
just
Mr.
a second,
Param
Navika.
Joy. I will allow you, Dr. Patra, but I have to settle a few points or questions that had been raised by Mr. Paranjoy. So let me just make the last point to him. The last point that I wish to make to you. You are accusing that the investigation officer that was appointed into
this. No, I'm not accusing that. You're putting words in my mouth. I would never said that.
Or you're insinuating.
I am stating a fact.
Okay. You are stating a fact that the investigation officer went back and
Don't put words in my mouth.
So what are you
don't
trying
put,
to say?
All I said, he was a brother of a BJP MLA. Don't put words in my mouth.
So did he?
Wait,
so what are you? If you are,
you've had your monologue. Will you give me time to give my monologue?
You are a journalist. And we journalists use our words very carefully.
I've been very careful in my using my words.
Unless a fact leads to a certain conclusion, we don't say those facts because normally, unlike the caravan which writes articles worth 10,000 words, we normally don't get the luxury of using so many.
You only spend a few hours on television.
Yeah.
That's all right.
Yeah, we don't get the luxury. I've worked in newspapers before, and we don't get the luxury of 10,000 words. We use facts which lead to some conclusion. So what is the conclusion that you are leading to, Mr. Paranjoy?
The conclusion I am leading to.
So you were leading to a conclusion.
No, you weren't leading to a conclusion.
Because you tried to allude to a fact that you weren't doing anything of the sort, but you were leading to a conclusion. So go on.
No, you
tell
never
us,
let me finish.
Tell us.
The conclusion I was alluding to, Navika Kumar, is that you are putting words in my mouth when I never said anything of the sort. I am saying, I repeat.
No, please, I want to come in over here, Navika.
You are trying to recycle an old story and passing it off as...
That's your judgment.
Please.
I need you.
See, you don't let me finish.
That is entirely...
Most importantly, Navika, I'm saying...
That is entirely your call. If you want to call it a recycled story, despite the fact that there were two reports that the caravan never had any copies of, which we put out for the first time yesterday. You're entitled to your opinion. Who am I to
but
take away your opinion
point, you're not letting
away
me finish.
From you because you have opinions on a lot of things which our viewers are in
so
any
do
case.
You.
My Lord,
so
I
do
want
you.
To cross-examine.
You are entitled to our opinion. Dr. Patra wants to come
Supreme
in before
Court,
I open this up.
When Doctor, the Supreme Court is seized of the matter, why is it so important for you to get Dr.
My Lord, allow me.
If the Supreme Court is seized of the matter, why was it so important for the organizers to actually hold that talk in the Capitol yesterday, the talk that was also attended by you? I can ask you the same question, but Dr. Sambit Patra wanted to come in. Yes, Dr. Sambit Patra.
Navika, in good jest, I am going to refer to you as me Lord, and I am going to cross-examine Justice Paranjoy Guha. Why I say so? We are seven people and you as the anchor over here, and we all are acting as if we are the bench of constitutional bench of judges hearing the case of Judge Loya, having no faith in the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is seized of the matter. The
and
Supreme
the
Court has called for all the documents from the Council of
State.
That's what I'm saying again
and
again.
Milord, you are the master of the roster. Please allow a junior judge to have a say. Milord,
okay.
You are the master
no,
of the roster.
Of
allow the junior
bench.
Judge to at least
Go
have
on.
A say, Milord.
You are the constitution.
Yes, please. Now, the most important point which I want to ask to Mr. Guha, whom I respect a lot. Mr. Guha, look, the innuendos of the Congress party and the politicians and the lobby that we are talking about is that the judge who are sitting in hearing of this case of Judge Loya, the bench in fact is quite junior, and the whole controversy is surrounding the judge's commitment, one bench hunting and forum shopping. My question is, only yesterday Times of India came up with these 15 extremely sensitive cases which were allocated to relatively junior judges. Now, I am interested in this particular PIL which was filed in 2012 in front of court number 8. The court number 8 in Supreme Court, it's a junior court, heard a PIL against Rahul Gandhi. And the PIL was about Sukanya Devi rape case. Rahul Gandhi was alleged to have raped Sukanya Devi. The PIL came to the Supreme Court. A junior judge I say junior judge bench, as per the paradise of talk nowadays, dispose that off. Did the Bharatiya Janata Party or any lobby in this country hold a press conference to say these are junior judges?
We are talking still about the investigation.
No, can I react to what Dr. Patra said?
Investigation, it is absolutely clear, my lord. The autopsy report, the ECG report, the doctors, journalists, everyone is to be kept aside. Only the lobby is to be heard as per them.
Yes,
only
because,
these conspiracies,
because the only
these people
Mr.
are the
Paranjoy
ones according to whom the conspiracies
is the caravan
exist.
Journalist. He is not convinced by
opinion.
Us.
That's your opinion.
He is not convinced by us.
No.
He calls
I'm
our
not convinced by you,
recycled,
but I'm convinced of many
report,
other journalists.
But he forgets that the Caravan magazine first talked about the RSS link, which has been
Can I ask a question to Guha? Guhaji,
Let me get in the others. Dr. John Dayal. Let the other brother judges also speak. Dr. John Dayal, why is there this concerted effort by this so-called lobby which was also speaking at this function yesterday? Why were they desperate to draw an RSS link to this, where none exists as we have demonstrated today?
All four of them, and I, in my concluding remarks, said this thing should be investigated. We have not... If we
but you've come to the conclusion that there's something wrong.
No.
Actually, you have come to the conclusion
it is the other way around. You know, excuse me. Can I also have 30 seconds as the only plaintiff here? You know, to say, to have a sting operation, it's all right to have a sting operation. Mm. And somebody says, somebody is from a Congress family. What are the Sindhias? Are they a Congress family? Are they a BJP family? What is this?
We have corroborated. Sir, you didn't hear the latter half. Didn't you hear Sheikh Mohiduddin Naimuddin?
Saying Congress?
Have you seen anybody's Aadhaar card?
I am calling for an investigation.
Congress or
I have seen nothing. I believe nothing.
We have corroborated Ladda's statement with Mohiduddin Naimuddin, who is the district chief.
Why should Ladda come and testify in the Supreme Court?
He is speaking in a sting operation. The other sister,
are you a Supreme Court?
Goa Thakurta,
no, are you a Supreme Court? When the Supreme Court is hearing the matter, here is Justice John Dayal calling for a de novo SIT. What is de novo SIT, by the way? What is de novo investigation? Why do we have Supreme Court in this country?
I never said SIT.
De novo investigation. Why should we have a de novo investigation?
To repeat Paranjoy's favorite phrase, you're putting words in my mouth. You can have an inquiry. Navika, please.
Two utterly wronged people sitting in the studio. The lobby that's
you
going after. There are two persecuted people. Let's not trivialize the debate.
The inquiry can be concluded in six months. First, what does
Paranjoy say? First, he says it's a recycled investigation yesterday and today. He says that the RSS link is absolutely a non-serious link because we have not asked
Bahati. I never said that. Again, you're putting words in my mouth. Actually, you should be feeling persecuted because all of us are saying again and again, you're putting words in my mouth. You know, can I respond to what Dr. Patra said? Because he addressed me on three or four occasions.
Make your point.
You know,
but he abused me.
No. He's talking about the Sukanya case and Rahul Gandhi. To this case, as Dr. Patra becoming an independent director of the Oil and Natural Gas Connection. It's no connection whatsoever.
Is he?
Secondly, You know, he's showered so many praises on me, and I'm greatly appreciative of what
you
he's
went
done.
To the court,
but I
the
agree
court
with him, Dr. Patra, I agree
the
with
same
you.
The same lobby went to the court
when
and
the Supreme Court was seized of the matter. Why should two police officers, why should Navika Kumar, why should Times Now be judging? All we are saying,
why should Rahul Gandhi hold a press conference
of the matter?
And why should Rahul Gandhi and Kavita Krishnan and Parijoy and John hold a press conference?
Mr. Paranjoy,
why should you hold a press conference and meet them?
Mr. Paranjoy, only the caravan and your friends
sir,
in the caravan magazine
is not
can judge. They can
put words into the
we can't. We can't. As a journalist, you have fair standards.
Are you
but
feeling
let me
persecuted, Navika?
I don't, sir. I don't. If I felt persecuted after yesterday, I wouldn't have invited you again
Thank
today.
Thank you so much. You're very
I
kind.
I am very happy to have you and your contrary opinion. Be my guest. Make as much of you, as much of the objections as you want about the investigations we do. We love to have you here. Make those objections. Let the people
you're
judge.
Very kind and you're very generous.
Yes, it's not generosity, it's just the job that I do, and I do my journalism in a certain way.
So do I.
That I've
so
learned.
Do I,
yeah, absolutely. We all do it. I have always had respect for you as a journalist.
Thank
when
you
did
much.
Journalism.
Thank
when
you very
you
much.
Journalism.
I still do it. That's an innuendo which is unwarranted. I still do journalism.
Mr. Hitesh Jain, why is there this deliberate attempt to bring up an RSS connection? And is the caravan all right in raising the RSS connection? But if we bust the theory of RSS connection, then it's not the journalism that is certified by some people in the studio here.
Well, Navika, I will tell you, there is one more court apart from Supreme Court in this country, and which I have realized, I mean, being a lawyer, I got the wisdom today, and that court is called Kangaroo's Court. And in Kangaroo's Court, you have Justice Thakur, Justice Dayal, the charge sheet is filed by the Caravan magazine. You know, in that Kangaroo Court, there is no evidence. There is like, you know, the accused is presumed guilty on the day one. Suspicion is good enough. There is, you can have a fishing and roving inquiry in Kangaroo Court. Anybody can come and speak anything. So in the Kangaroo Court, the fact that in 2014 also they wanted to bring the Sohrabuddin angle is ignored. In the Kangaroo Court, the fact that on the eve of the Gujarat election caravan article came, that has to be ignored. In the Kangaroo Court, Indian Express detailed investigation rebutted to caravan magazine came, that has to be ignored. Two sitting judges of the Bombay High Court. Now, their integrity, not a single activist has questioned. So nobody is speaking about them giving a detailed account, how those judges were present, what happened during the postmortem, how the High Court judges reached the site, how some judges accompanied the Judge Loya to his native town. All these facts have to be ignored. 2019 is coming. There is a convenient narrative to be fixed. Amit Shah was the person who delivered in 2014. Somewhere, you know, instead of fighting him politically, let's fix him. That has been the strategy since 2004, 2009, 2014. And this Kangaroo Court, their lawyers, judges, these are the people, they come in and then they make all kinds of this thing. But they forget the fact. People are there, I mean, people are laughing at them, they're making a laughing stock of themselves. So I think they should smell
why,
the coffee.
In this
Kangaroo
Court,
this is enough.
Why
politics,
are you such a
if they
chicken?
Want to fight,
why
come
don't
and
you
fight in the elections,
why?
Fight on the
you
real
are
issues.
Being a
don't fight such backroom
you are
matters.
Being a coward.
Or don't try
just
to do this political fixing.
By asking for
on
an inquiry.
27th November, when this article in Caravan came, I said this was an attempt to divide the judiciary. This was a point attempt to fix political investigation. So this Kangaroo Court people, they can say anything.
So let me get
they
in
not,
Mr. Rajiv
they have
Rajiv
zero
Rai.
Credibility.
What have you got in your
so let me get in Mr. Rajiv Rai. Mr. Rajiv Rai, do you think there is a deliberate attempt to create a narrative just because there are elections in 2019 and you ask for an investigation, drag this right up to 2019 and try and corner Amit Shah and Narendra Modi? Isn't that part of the narrative that is being read? Is this part of that? Conspiracy?
On narratives, I can speak for half an hour.
Navika, are you serious asking these questions to me? I mean, already the full constitutional bench is sitting there. So many brother judges are there. I don't know whether constitutional bench or Kangaroo Court, but let me make it very clear. I'm not the part of either judicial, I mean, full court or Kangaroo Court. Navika, basic question is this. The questions, I mean, certain objections were raised by the four senior judges of the Supreme Court. It is not raised by Congress, BJP or anybody or Samajwadi Party. What is wrong in looking into that? Assume I am a common voter of this country. We have two media houses, one is Kerala and another one is Times Now. I am watching, hearing and reading of both the media houses, and I have all the right to know what is the truth. We are not, neither you are saying that you are wrong or Caravan is right or Caravan is wrong or you are right. I mean, the moment you express your opinion, you are no part of lobby, you are trying to malign, trying to implicate, all the branding is given. Now, there are certain points which has been raised by Caravan also. Better to the point, I reply to that. And whatever the, I mean, you come out and say, it is courts or judicial internal matter, government will not interfere. But the same court, when the rights for the memorandum of procedure, you sit there for 1 year, same court recommends name of around 80 judges for the Supreme Court, you reject, make it appoint only 40 judges. Same judge, I mean, courts when they recommend for the 15,000 in the lower courts, you don't approve that, there you are interfering because it suits you.
The point you are making, Mr. Rajiv Rai...
This is the onus on the government. They have to come clean on the
Navika,
Mr. Rajiv Rai, the only point I am asking you is that if there were facts, fair enough, everybody, every media house has a right to raise the facts. Nobody is questioning that. And I, least of all, will question the facts and the rights of journalists to raise facts as, you know, a legitimate right to do so. But the question I am asking is, why is there a deliberate twist? Why is there a deliberate twist that Judge Roya was taken in an auto rickshaw to Dande Hospital? Why is there a deliberate attempt to say that there was an RSS man called Baheti who called?
Why is there a deliberate twist to say nobody accompanied the dead body?
Some of these discrepancies are rather pronounced. So I'm asking questions which have been raised by different groups and different media houses. We are asking for impartial inquiry. Let the Supreme Court now hear the only part of the judgment here. Okay, Dinesh Vashne, do you think there is an attempt, or do you also belong to the same group which says there should be an impartial inquiry, even at a time when the Supreme Court is absolutely seized of the matter? It's hearing the matter, it heard it this morning, it's posted it for another 7 days, it's given for all the documents to be placed before it. But at the same time, with this narrative going on all around, you know, being played out in the public domain, is there an attempt to prejudice the court as well?
No, I am a leader of the CPI. I don't belong to any lobby. I have only one question to ask Navika, to all of you, including all journalists. Whom are we trying to save? By not asking the inquiry under a proper bench.
But why are we also trying to raise questions where there are none?
Look. As a matter of propriety, I object to this. What is an improper bench? What is an improper bench? Please do so.
No, Navika, I object to this.
What is proper bench and what is improper bench? Please get this defined right now over here. I want the panelists over here to define what is a proper bench of Supreme Court and what is the improper bench of Supreme Court.
Can't I call my view? I'm waiting for 36 minutes.
What is a proper bench of Supreme Court?
You are welcome.
And what is an improper bench of Supreme Court? I want this definition and clarification, Navika. I object to this. I object to this. I object to this. What is a proper bench? What do you mean by a proper bench of Supreme Court?
His sister.
No, what is proper bench of Supreme Court? Please define that. Define proper bench of Supreme Court and improper bench of Supreme Court.
Do you think Justice Mishra led bench is not a proper bench?
I am coming to that. I will come to that. I am asking you one thing.
Who are you to comment on
the bench? Yesterday I objected. I refused to accept the police.
No. This needs clarification.
That police officer is a relative.
This needs clarification on one of the most important channels of the country. We hear an important politician saying that Supreme Court has improper benches also. This is contempt. He needs to clarify.
That's a different temperature from Mumbai to Nagpur. What are you talking?
Mr. Dinesh Vasne and Mr. Paranjoy.
His body was sent to his father, mother, not to his wife and
son. No, I need to come in over here.
When you talk, when you talk about a certain hospital owner being related to some BJP person, when you talk about an investigation officer being related to some BJP person, we can say some judges are related to some Congress people.
Say,
some
Congress Gogoi is related.
There are some doctors
say,
who are.
See, say no. that doctor.
Say
doctor.
Say Ranjan Gogoi. So, I am not saying that so and so is related to Congress.
Chief
Minister Sindhia
is
related to Congress.
Let Dr. Sambit Patra.
So what? But his mother is not. She is with the BJP.
That's why I'm again and again using proper. I know what I want to say.
Don't put words in my mouth. Don't put words in my mouth. Same to you. I'm not insinuating anything. All I'm saying is, when you can propound theories like that, everybody can propound theories like that. I am asking you, why don't you explain your statement, a proper bench of the Supreme Court?
Because when a journalist asked Justice Gogoi, do you think that it is also a case related to Justice Loya, that Mr. Gogoi almost on say in affirmative. Justice Gogoi.
Can I please come in? So do you suggest
that Justice Gogoi belong to some lobby? Are you suggesting that?
No, but that's where this entire issue started. Supreme Court, Chief Justice, come by matter of seniority.
All cases, insensitive cases, related to the state,
allow me to come in over here.
Not only in India, in Canada, America, Australia, from the ground, the conclusion
is that I need to come in over here.
Dr. Patra, Navika one wrong cannot be justified by another wrong.
But why not have an inquiry?
Why are you? Whom are you
first and foremost, I have taken an exception and an objection. Just a second. I have taken an objection to the kind of adjective that has been used. That has been used by Professor Vasne, that there was a proper bench should have heard this case. I firmly believe that this is condemnable because every bench in Supreme Court, whoever says this, I firmly believe that the Supreme Court, all the judges are respected and every bench in Supreme Court is proper. And now let me answer. Please don't interject and intervene. Allow me to complete. You just now used proper bench. And you should apologize. But allow me to complete.
Okay, Navika, I would read out those important cases.
Which, in fact, yes.
Yeah. Make your point, Dr. Sambit Patra.
Navika, I will just read out some of the cases. I'll just in 10 seconds read out some of the important cases that went to court number 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, that is relatively junior courts. Rajiv Gandhi assassination case in 1998. Rajiv Gandhi assassination case was that... Can I please speak, Navika? Navika, I am making a very important point. Can I please speak without interference? Can I please speak, Navika, without interference by Mr. Professor Vasne? Professor Vasne, you are a professor. Don't shout in the middle of the debate like this. Allow others to make the points and then you can come in. Learn behavior from Mr. Guha. He never shouts. Please learn from John Dayal. He never shouts in the middle. Allow me to speak.
Okay, let me get into those important cases which went to the junior cases. Mr. Rajiv Desai.
No, let me please complete.
Okay.
Let me please complete. These are important issues which the people should know. Rajiv Gandhi assassination case 1998.
You are also continuously speaking.
Please allow me.
Allow him to finish and I will come to you.
This is not the way.
That's a fair way to do this.
Dr. Patra, it is not my statement only. It is also the chest.
Please allow me. This is not the way. They are being cornered and they won't allow me to speak. This is the wrong way.
Must be heard by the senior judges.
I play that soundbite, Mr. Dinesh Vasne. Mr. Dinesh Vasne, we'll play
but
that
please allow me,
allow
please,
to finish
please
and then
allow
I
me
allow
to speak
you.
And thereafter
you also allow me to speak.
Yeah,
please.
We'll do so.
Uninterrupted.
Yeah. Navika, let me ask some questions through your channel to people of this country. Rajiv Gandhi assassination case 1998, it went to court number 8. Was it not an important case or a sensitive case? Bofors case of 1999 went to court number 8, Justice M.B. Shah. Was it not an important or a sensitive case? Best Bakery case of 2004 went to court number 11. Was it not important case? Disqualification of MPs, MLAs, union conviction and sentencing of 2 or more years went to court number 9. Was it not an important case? Ram Jethmalani's black money case went to court number 9. Was it not an important case? Rahul Gandhi's murder charges went to court number 8. Was it not an important case? Validity of section 66A went to court number 11. Was it not important? Coal scam case 2012 went to court number 7. The question is, all these, despite the fact that they were junior judges, these are all proper bench then. These lobbies did not interject then. Today, suddenly they demand a proper bench. They say, how dare a junior Supreme Court judge hear a case? Look at these hypocrites. This is a clear case of hypocrisy. And let me ask you a question.
When the matter is Supreme Court.
No, Mr. Let me try and understand what Mr. Patra is saying. That other cases were in the other courts, so these four justices have raised a spurious issue, and that therefore he is in fact in contempt of these four justices. He's saying that they have raised an irrelevant issue
justice.
Because cases
look
have been assigned
justice.
In the past.
Look at this conspiracy.
That's one thing. But the most
Why
important
keep quiet?
Thing is
I will not keep quiet. You kept on disturbing me when I was speaking.
Angst.
I will speak when my brother judge speaks. I will interject.
That is evident.
I'll expose him.
In this discussion and in other
discussions. Why didn't you question when the coal scam case went to court number 8?
They are. Oh, please keep quiet, Dr. Patra. I'm speaking. Behave yourself.
He can't.
I'm speaking. I'm saying
what behave yourself. All of you are misbehaving in front of the Supreme Court.
If they only let the investigation be, there would have been no problem, but they cannot let the investigation be.
So who will decide about the investigation? You, me, or the Supreme Court?
This is a cover up.
Who will decide about the investigation?
And Dr.
Patra,
sure
the Supreme Court will take the final call. Not Mr. Rajiv Desai or Rahul Gandhi.
Call on that, Mr. Rajiv Desai or not?
Many people
or will you sit and take a decision on that?
Lawyer, about the assignment of cases, let
yeah.
there be an inquiry.
Justice
What's
Desai
wrong
will
with
take
it?
A decision
What's
over
wrong
here
with having an
in this debate.
Well, why would you want to argue about questions? We begin to ask about the behavior of judges. Only 50 seconds. I'm giving you 60 seconds. Look, Navika.
I have not. When I said proper bench or proper court, that does not mean that I have a disrespect for court number 7, 8, 9, 10, out to 20. I only mean to say even same thing
so
has been said by the Supreme
then?
Court Bar Association. They said from Monday onward all judges will sit and all sensitive cases must go to senior judges' benches. What does it
so
mean?
So the Supreme Court Bar Association
are you
will
also
the lawyers
the
of this country
member?
Saying,
Mr.
the lawyers of this country
Mr.
saying, number two,
Mr.
are you the master of the law?
Please give me 50 seconds. Number two, when a journalist asks Honorable Justice Gogoi,
Professor Vasne will become the master of the roster sitting here on Times now. He will start allocating cases now.
In case of Justice Loya death, he said yes.
इनको जल्दी जल्दी घर जाने दीजिए नाविका जी घर जाके रोस्टर भी बनाना है कल कौन सा जज कौन सा केस सुनेगा
डॉक्टर पात्रा
इनको जल्दी जल्दी घर जाने दीजिए
जस्टिस पात्रा यू आर वेलकम टू हैव दी सेफ।
वह आप जल्दी जल्दी घर जाके रोस्टर बनाइए, आप जल्दी जाइए
जस्ट बिकॉज लॉयर्स ऑफ दिस कंट्री नितेश जैन जस्ट बिकॉज वन मिनट जस्ट बिकॉज लॉयर्स ऑफ दिस कंट्री फील दैट सीनियर जजेस शुड बी गिवन द यू नो पीआईएल्स एंड अदर इंपॉर्टेंट मैटर्स, इज द सीजेआई, इज द चीफ जस्टिस ऑफ इंडिया बाउंड बाय दैट? And does that take away from the narrative that is being spread, the RSS narrative, the foul play in the death narrative? You know, is one thing playing over the other in this entire case?
Navika, the lawyers of the country are not disputing. It is just a few vested interest people they are calling and they are deciding the assignment of the Supreme Court. This is a very bad precedent. This is what happens. There is a judgment of the Supreme Court which clearly says the Chief Justice is the master of the roster.
You are the lawyers
of the specialist. This is a dangerous
flow we are doing. Gentlemen, all.in/news.r. My viewers are sending in their comments and these are leading comments. Listen to what my viewers feel. Deepak Rai says these Modi haters not able to defeat him in elections or trying their level best for 2019, even judiciary is being used now. Mrs. Deepak Rai, I don't know what
I think
he is.
He's a Modi lover.
Mrs. Mukherjee says, isn't it ridiculous to think that a judge was taken to a hospital in an auto rickshaw and nobody accompanied him?
That is the point. Investigate.
It's been proven. Several depositions there on that. Ramachandran TH says, the left has lost sight and are being guided by an already blind Congress. Is that the way for the left to go?
These are the questions viewers are asking tonight.
But as I thank all my panelists, the judgment is up to you, ladies and gentlemen. Why is there a desperate attempt to try and lead a narrative in a specific direction? There are statements, there are a lot of proofs that exist to show that there was a problem in the coronary functioning of Justice Loya. The medical reports show that. The RSS theory has been busted tonight. What more is required to prove? Well, we leave the judgment to you, dear viewers. Thank you very much for joining me here on debate number one. Debate number two with Anand Narasimhan coming up on the News Hour at 10 on the other side of this very short break.